Hi everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another video at my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be using the new Critter Crowd stamp set from Simon Says Stamp. This is part of their STAMPtember 2019 release. And I thought this stamp set in particular would be good to show a technique that I use quite a bit, which is precision stamping with the use of a stamp map. So I created a stamp map in a recent video. I'll link it up in the very top corner if you want to check that out. But I stamped a bunch of art supplies on the bottom of an envelope. And a stamping map really helped me get the perfect placement of all those different images. That same method is going to help me build this scene with this group of critters and then all the separate little elements that you can add on top. So I'm stamping on some graph paper. This is just some MISTI graph paper that I've cut down a little bit smaller. And I'm using all of these little images and building my scene. I'm not paying attention to how the lines are intersecting or anything like that. I just want to get them on here so I have a scene built. I'm going to use this stamp map when I do my stamping on the actual finished card. So I'm cutting it down just so I have that precise area. It's a little bit off center and I wanted to make sure that I would be able to center this. The watercolor paper I'm using today is from Fabriano. This is the Artistico Extra White. And I'm going to set that paper aside for just a minute while I figure out which of these little images need to be created into masks. So you notice that I've got some intersecting lines on that hat, on the penguin, and then also there's the intersecting line of the balloons on this monkey. Now I will have to create one more additional mask here. I didn't think I would, but then I realized that I did, and you'll see that here in a minute. So now I have some masking paper, and I'm going to stamp those two images that need to have masks, and I'm just stamping that in some black ink onto Simon Says Stamp masking paper. And then I took some scissors and fussy cut out the images that I needed to have masks for. So I've got the little party hat, and then I also have the monkey. So I'm going to set those aside for a minute, and I'll start my stamping. So here's my watercolor paper. I'm placing my stamp map on the front of the watercolor paper, and then I'm going to take a piece of tape. You could use any masking tape. I'm just using some, I think it's 1.5 inch wide Thermaweb purple tape, and it's going to tape that mask in place so that I can flip it up out of the way when I start stamping. So I'm placing that party hat stamp directly over that penguin, and then I'm going to make sure my paper is perfect. I'm going to fold back the map, and then I'm going to use some waterproof ink to stamp this. I'm using some Versafine Onyx Black ink, and I'll just stamp that down onto the watercolor paper. So now I'm going to take that mask for the party hat, and I'm going to place that over the top of what I've already stamped, and then I'm going to swing that map back over, and I can start positioning the next stamp. So the next thing I need to stamp is that large line of animals. So I have that positioned. Then I'm going to adjust my paper in my MISTI here, make sure it's nice and snug in that corner. Double check, but don't mind my head in the way. Double check to make sure that placement's just right. And then I can stamp this large line of animals. And that's going to have the penguin perfectly placed right underneath that party hat. And I actually ended up stamping the animals twice so that I could get a more solid black line. When you're stamping onto watercolor paper like this, sometimes the texture of the watercolor paper prevents getting a really solid line. So I like to use a MISTI stamp positioning tool for this because that means I can stamp it multiple times. So now I'm placing the mask of the little monkey over the top of his face. And now I should be able to stamp the balloons. So I'm, I'm putting the circular balloon stamp right over top. I'll transfer that to the door of my MISTI, and then I can swing that map back over, and then double checking once again, and then I can ink up that stamp and swing the door over and stamp that in place. At this point, this is when I realized I needed another mask for the balloon. So while there was still a little bit of residual ink on that stamp, I brought in that masking paper once again, and I put it in the placement where that balloon would be and just stamped that down. I then cut out just the circle shape of the balloon since it was only going to be intersecting with the heart-shaped balloon right around that area, and I placed that over the top of the circular balloon. I was then able to position the heart balloon, and I put that on the door of my MISTI, and then stamped that down using that same waterproof black ink. This is going to make it look like the round balloon is in front of the heart balloon. For the next little bit, I had all these little images that are kind of filling in the gaps above the animals, and so I placed them all, and I transferred all of these images to the door of my MISTI all at the same time. So I'm going to position that paper in there, just make sure it's nice and snug. Double checking to make sure your watercolor paper is in the right spot is never a bad idea. And I'm double checking again. And then I'll stamp all of those images in that black ink. It's a great way to just fill in all those gaps above all of the animals' heads and get it all done in one stamping. I don't have to do this over and over again. I can do it all at once. So the last thing to add for the images is this little love you greeting in the little talk bubble above the bear. Then stamped the happy birthday, and then I also stamped the from all of us down at the bottom. So this is the grouping of all of these images that I put together, and I'm going to remove those three masks that I created earlier, and I like to just save them on the back of my stamp set, just in case I need them again or if I want to recreate this card. Then remove the balloon mask and also the monkey's face mask. And those were all of the masks. Now I have my whole greeting and images area ready to paint. So I'm going to be using some Mijello Mission Gold paints today. These are some that I use all the time, and I really love them. I've taped down my watercolor piece to a board here, and I'm just going to speed up the painting process and turn on a bit of music. I'll be back when the painting is finished. I decided I wanted a little bit more detail on the outer frame of this watercolor piece, so I took the large dots stencil from Simon Says Stamp, and I'm going to put a little bit of white pigment ink on here. I was hoping that just the pigment ink on its own would be enough to show the dot pattern, but unfortunately this white pigment ink wasn't strong enough, especially since I really wasn't stamping it on there, just blending a little bit. You couldn't really see the pattern very much. So after I peeled up the stencil and kind of moved it over to the side so I could continue that dot pattern, Then I decided that instead of having it just be the pigment ink, which really wasn't showing up very much, I thought it'd be kind of cool to have some embossing powder. So I'm using some translucent pearl embossing powder from Altenew. This is a clear embossing powder that has very small, fine flecks of glitter. So I thought it would just look really, really nice right on top of all of these dots, give it a little bit of texture and a little bit of sparkle and shine on those outer edges. So I just sprinkled that on and tapped off the excess. And then I hit it with my heat tool, and it left just enough of that dot pattern to give a little interest to the outer edge. I then used the Waffle Flower A7 Layers dies to cut out this entire watercolor piece, and so that it would be the perfect size for a 5x7 card. So I just popped that out of that die after I ran it through my Gemini Junior machine, and now it's ready for the card front. So I created a card base out of some Nina Solar White 110-pound cardstock, and then I put some foam adhesive on the back of my watercolor panel and then directly onto the front of the card. At this point, I decided I wanted to add a few details to the scene, so I took a number 10 jelly roll pen. This is the white color. I added some polka dots to the balloon and also the party hat, and then some stars and dots on the heart-shaped balloon. I then took some Nouveau Crystal Glaze, and I added the glaze to not only the happy birthday at the very bottom, but I also added it to the balloons, the talk bubble, the party hat, and the stars. And as far as working on these very small letters, I kind of dabbed the glaze down and moved it along. And then for areas where it kind of bled outside the letters, I just used the pointy end of some tweezers to scrape away any of that glaze. So it's nice and shiny, and that's going to dry back completely clear. Added more onto that balloon, and that completely finishes the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed this fun idea on how to do some precision stamping with a stamping mask. I like to use this technique a lot, and it helps me plan out my cards even better. You can pick up the stamp set, which is called Critter Crowd, over at simonsestamp.com. I'll have links down below for you to click over and shop directly. And thank you so much when you do that. That helps support my YouTube channel and helps me bring 3 videos to you every single week. As I close out this video, I want to remind you that if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, you definitely can do that. And also hit the bell next to that subscribe button. That makes it so that you'll be notified whenever I post a new video. Hit that thumbs up button if you liked this video. And thank you so much for watching. I will catch you guys very soon with another card video.